getting up there. I mean, this is somewhere I can get to without any issues. See, there's another power gem over here, so I mean, I know I'm not done. Right. That looks like some sort of keyhole over there as well. Yeah, it's a spider. Definitely feel like I'm missing something. Well, obviously. Yeah, because this is like the back plate that I saw over there. Right? Pew pew, crossbow. Yeah, that is the case. Starving has, I mean, it doesn't help you, but it's not gonna kill you, just due to the way that it works in this game. Love, like, this nub, like, right up here. Always looks like it's something. But it's just another rock. It is just another rock. So this was the secret button for this. That's not anything useful. I wonder what would happen if I used a rope to go down to a spot where there isn't, like, ground to stand on. Would I just, like, go down a level and then fall the rest of the distance? I can hear something beyond this. Like fire elementals or something. Yeah. Well, tally ho. Awesome. fun. Ba-ba-ba. Wilson doesn't have legs? Well, that's weird. He's wearing these fine leather pants. Okay, so this is all this stuff. Wait, isn't there a ceiling there? I mean, I guess not. Yeah. There isn't a ceiling here either. And I could rappel down here, if I could reach it. Not that I want to, because it's pointless. Hmm. Please respect the lore and remove the pants. Let's re-examine this area. I mean, I know it's a secret, but maybe it has something of value that was otherwise left, I don't know, unstolen. Doesn't seem that way. Okay. So it's this platform, which I can't really do anything else with. I mean, you know, cool stuff, but not really going anywhere with it. This area, which is sealed. I suppose it's possible that there's another button in here somewhere that allows me to get over here. I kind of looked around that place, though. Quite a bit. Damn. And this stuff. I've got. Don't remember if I searched these frames for, like, buttons and stuff, because there was something going on here for sure. This is another way out. Almost makes me wonder if there's some sort of interaction between these two maps. You know, with all of this going on. Alright, boys. Have a good one. Thanks for stopping by. It's a simulacrum room. Okay. Back to looking for secret thingies. I don't think I... Because the first one of these that I found was up there. So it could be that I've passed by a lot of... Well, maybe not a lot, but... I've passed by some amount of secret buttons greater than zero on these things. And that is rather untenable. Quite so. Though this could just be... Yeah. Oh dear. Oh, Mara's dead. Ow. Yoink. Those phoenix things are just awful. Tremendously difficult to do anything against. Particularly when you are surprised. Okay. Damn, is that all we're gonna see in here? I was really hoping for something more. Something with a little progress attached to it. Well, that explains all of the noise from over here. I remember hearing, like, fiery things flying around. And thinking that that might be something. And it was, just not quite the fashion I was hoping. Everyone else has, like, some reasonable amount of resist fire, or, like, quite a bit. I mean, Hector doesn't have a lot, but he also has, you know, a lot more health. Okay, well that deals with that. I might go up there and take a look. Have a look-see. See what I can find as far as more secret buttons are concerned. Secret trademark buttons. Oh, these are all up. Except for that one. Okay. Dear. There it is. Okay. Well, down we go. Alright, Dex. Thanks for stopping by, and thank you for the luck. Dude, there isn't even a level above this. What's up here? Secret found. Well, yeah, I guess. Zafi Khakis. Well, these are terrible. Zafi Robe. Also terrible. What's in the box? Bunch of stuff. So, 5 more cannonballs. 20 more pellets, that's actually quite welcome. Welcome. A saber. Okay, let's put this down here for a moment. Zafi Shima. Lara is overburdened. You know what, Dread? Carry that. Another way out. Excuse me? Wilson's injured. Wow, well, these things are, less challenging. I mean, these things have a lot of armor, but Dread is doing so much damage now that it really doesn't matter. Okay. This is another way out. More like just another way in. But I like the connectedness. That's nice. So, this saber, 16 to 49. It's actually better for straight damage. Has a lower cooldown. And adds 5 critical. And comes with flurry of slashes. Series of 3 quick slashes with deadly accuracy. Holy shit. I mean, this ignores 25 points of armor, but this might just be really good. Technically not a way in since it only opened from the inside. Yeah. There's more stuff over here, because I know you could move around and whatnot. There's a warg around here somewhere, though. And it is going to get just... Okay, never mind. Dread is just going to miss. It's fine. Ow. It's not nice. Please die. Okay. I wanna find out this flurry of slashes and its deadly accuracy. Come on. That's pretty nice. You know? That is pretty nice. Wait, come here, you. Get attacked by this huge weapon. Oh, wow. There are more of them. Well, more food. It's kind of nice. I kind of want, I kind of want to go back to the hub and drop some of this crap, but that's a little ways away, so I'm not going to bother. Head injury. Unable to cast spells. The terror. Alright, let's go back to the mines. And find out what's over here. If anything. This just feels really not good. You know? Alright, what's in the bag? More alchemical ingredients. Quite a few more. And another bag. Okay, so this is going to be a bag where I'm going to put, you know, shit that maybe I don't need or want to carry around, things and stuff. Yep, sure. Okay. Well, it's something. It's something, but it's not helping me with all the other stuff down here. So I've got this door, which I need to open. I think I looked for secret buttons, but maybe I wasn't thorough enough. And I'm not getting through here without the mine key. And then there's another closed gate right here, with a whole bunch of spiders on the other side. So, I mean, maybe this loops around or something. And then, you know, this opens as more of a convenience or something to get back. Because if I had to bet, opening this mine keyhole leads around here, and then it comes upstairs over here so you can grab, like, the power gem. And then you can go back down the stairs and then kind of come back around here because this is the way to get out. Ow. That was my jaw. That's my line of thinking, anyway. Just from the way that the level is laid out. Hey, Gene Twitch. Is this the new Commander Keen? Yeah, Mortimer McMeyer is at it again. Wait, what was that? A ruined box and ore crate. So violent. Hmm. Where did you come from, little guy? One damage. He's running around out here. I suppose there's a distinct possibility that these things respawn because I traveled all the way over to the you know. Yeah. I think that's what it is. I'm gonna finish looking around over here, just to kind of confirm it. But I get the feeling that these things are just, like, respawns for this area. It does seem like the saber is doing maybe less damage than the maul, just because of the differences in the armor penetration. I don't seem to be getting, like, the same, like, really high damage values. Though that could just be a series of unlucky hits. Because on paper it does more damage, but the other one ignores 25 points of armor, which I mean, it's pretty significant. How much faster is it? By like 1.5 seconds, I think? Yeah, the cooldown on this is 6. Of which Dread has a 10% benefit because he has dodge level 3, the perk. So that means that the cooldown for this will be 5.4 seconds. And this will be, you know, 4.05 seconds. Plus it's got like the extra critical, which is nice, but perhaps not necessary. What is this? Is that just decorative? Or is there actually something to these lightning rocks on the ceilings? Okay, maybe it's just decorative. Oh, that hit 185 though. That triple attack though is really nice. I mean, it's a way better special than the knockback. way better special. I mean, particularly if Dredd is dishing out the hurt like that. You know, no complaints about that kind of thing. How do spiders have armor? Yeah, most insects have, you know, like a reasonably durable carapace for their size, you know, when they're dealing with other insects and that kind of thing, I think. You know, exoskeletons, stuff like that. Pretty sure I checked here, though. A second time, I mean. So, nothing of interest here, 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 here. Don't have anything going on there. No buttons or anything here. Or here. Or here. We're just stuck with another door. Huh. Each hit checks for crit, which is too bad. Imagine if there was only one crit for all three. That would be obscene. I don't know. A lot of the things in this game have, like, way better stats than the party, so it wouldn't surprise me if they had better than 25 protection or armor. Hmm. I mean, I'm assuming that there is a second mine key for, like, down here. You know, I got one on this level, and I used it, like, over here or somewhere. No, it was to get into this area. This was the first mine key to get in here, which I obtained in this room from the simulacrum puzzle. And then I got another key on this level, which I used for this door, and then came in here and I got a power gem from down here. There's another power gem on this level, which I may need to travel over here to get, but then it might be just like a trade-off, like, hey, you get one of the power gems, but not both. I don't think that's the case, though. I think there's another mine key. You know, there's certainly other areas to explore down here, but I'm not currently in a position where it's going well. That won't do what I think it's going to do, and I know it won't. Is there anything else down here, though, that was of any interest? I mean, I don't think so, because I was fucking around looking at all of these different walls, looking for other secrets. I was pretty thorough when I was down here, because I was thinking about the, you know, the puzzle up here. I was a little bit spoiled. A little bit. Not dramatically, but enough. Certainly. And then this was the Forge of the Fallen Stars. Hmm. Chitin set was good in Grimrock 1. Yeah, that's true. For the first playthrough, which Grimrock is better to start with? I would agree with Pjoxt. I think the first one is much better to start with. It's more I don't know. I think the linearity of it helps a little bit. Probably. I don't think there's anything over there that I can jump onto. Is there? Maybe I've been missing it. It's kind of hard to see that distance, though. So we have a bunch of stuff kind of over this way. Maybe? Eh, the worst thing that's gonna happen is I'm gonna save it, and then I'm gonna drop down, and then I'm gonna break everyone's legs. Tally-ho! Yeah, well, that worked out. So, it does give me some information about what's over here, but it's not helpful. Dread has an injury of some sort. Probably a serious one. And then I'm quite sure that there isn't anything to be gained by dropping down, like, here? Or is there? Oi, oi, oi! Fucking hell. You can barely see that pressure plate from beyond the torch there. Yeah. Hey, dude, it's my throwing axe. Fucking bollocks. Crap. Is there another pressure plate over there? I can see maybe something. God dang it. All right, let's just hang on. Okay. Fucking. Alright, maybe it's more of the same. You know, like, there's some other thing that I need to throw stuff at. Right? No? I can see the mine key over there. Or is this a dual-purpose switch? Maybe I was so excited that I saw one gate. Actually, I think I heard the other one close. Maybe. Yeah, okay. Just hang on a second. You know, I have important not fighting you work to complete for a moment here. Dick. Okay. I don't need to cast that. Gotta say, I'm not thoroughly impressed with the lightning sword. I was correct. I mean, because it doesn't do physical damage, it's not... it's not subject to the kinds of defenses, like physical defenses against it, that you would otherwise have. But I do miss out on... I do miss out on the thrust, which... I mean, you know, like, Hector has the ability to use, like, a couple of those in a combat, and they're actually quite good. Plus the fact that it is straight up more actual damage, and the cooldown is substantially better. And the fact that this skills with strength isn't huge, it's just like one more. Yeah. I think I'll go with this. What's this? Another bear pelt. Vitality 2, resist cold. Yeah, sure. Evasion doesn't exactly seem to be the relevant part of this build for the time being. Okay. Check for secret stuff. Okay, there's the mind key. Sweet. That doesn't sound good. Do we have to do this? I suppose that's a problem. I need to wait for them to help me. Does that mean the spiders ate a friggin' bear? I don't know. Anything's possible. Turn around. Thank you. Come get it. Oh, 230. Holy shit. Okay, I like this weapon. This weapon's real good. We've got some food, which I'll just kind of dole out, I guess, because people need to eat. And I have another sack. Okay. So, now that I've finally worked out these frickin' things, we're in an excellent position to move on with our new mine key. Oh. Progress is satisfying. Guess que say? Maybe one of these spitting things? Looks like we have... Can you put sacks into sacks? You cannot. You know, when you open one, if you click on, like, it doesn't work, sadly. It sacks all the way down. Like that. Okay. So this is on timer, and then this is all doing stuff. Does this just lead down here? It does not. We're going spelunking, folks. Spikes. And a teleporter. And I can see something glowing over there. I see. Okay, so this is also above this area. Bah. Are all of these closed? This all looks like it just leads into the giant spike chamber, which is kind of scary. Okay, we have a lever here, which opens this. It's just a hop, skip, and jump to the other side. Quite so. And these all go into this area down here. So we've got another catch. I kind of want to go down there because there's, you know, shiny, delicious green things. But I also don't want to go down there because it seems like there are... I have to stop doing that. Yeah, I don't want to get a spike shoved in my ass. Lara made a level. Nice. So Hector will be right behind her. So there was, like, one fight in which Hector was dead and did not get experience for some rather nice... Oh, wow. Someone got destroyed, and then I took a fart cloud in the face. Okay. So, I could keep putting points into accuracy for the benefit of making sure I hit with something like this. I still kind of like the idea of that. I could start putting some into, like, missile weapons and stuff. But for the moment, accuracy it is. Okay. So... Oh, maybe this thing fired the gaseous cloud. Alright. Yeah. Do they keep firing, or is it just one shot? One and done. Lightning bombs. Well, a lightning bomb. That's just a spider. There's just a helmet sitting here. Is that really what's going on? Is that what you're trying to tell me? Yep, apparently there is just a helm just sitting here. So, meteor helm. 18 protection. Dark metal helmet seems to be shaped from a single block of meteor stone. Yoink. And now I have two full helmets. I don't need two full helmets. This full helmet can piss off. There is going to be definitely an argument, I think, at some point to gain the last point of armor for Hector. It's an extra 5%, which would be like another 5 armor. Or close to it at this point. Which isn't a tremendous amount, but it's kind of neat. Climbing interrupted. Oh no. Ow. 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 Please stop killing my party members. Archmage's loafers. And crystal shard of healing. All wounds and raises dead champions back to life. That's cute. Thanks. Alright. Well, I could use one of these to get him back to life, but that would seem like a tremendous waste. I could just give him a potion of resurrection. Or I could just say, fuck it, he's gonna die again. So I'm not gonna really worry about it. And as long as I get to the end with these two, I'm perfectly fine. Because then I'll just go visit, like, a save crystal or something. So anyway, let's put protection 3, willpower 1, resist all. Yeah, there you go, buddy. And now you can throw those away. Wilson's dead, but Vilson is doing just fine. Okay. So, these two. I don't really like the idea of saving down here. Didn't I just save, like, before I jumped down? Yeah, maybe not. That was 2 minutes ago. Fuck it, we're saving. Ow. Okay, I'm out. Good. So I do need a crystal of not being dead. Ideally. So let's shimmy on over here. Everything's fine. Wrong way. Alright, Goonie. I'm probably not going to be too long here. I might see if I can finish up what might be the last of the Crystal Mines. And then I might call it a night myself. But thanks for stopping by. It's always good to have company. That isn't spiders. You know, non-spider company. It's pretty good. Spiders did nothing wrong. Except live. I'm perfectly okay with, I'm perfectly okay with that. I don't have any problems. Spiders do not have to do things wrong for me to want to kill them. Alright, so more critical for shipwreck. And nothing cool here. Wait a minute. Okay, it's just this little thing in the wall. And then we have this door, which is now open. And we have a bow. And some other stuff. Okay, so broadhead arrows. And a lightning bow. So, 9 to 28 plus dexterity, 4.5 second cooldown. Requires missile weapons 4 and air magic 1? Bloody hell. So, 9 to 28 plus dexterity. So, her dexterity is 21 right now, so we're talking 30 to 49. Which is a little bit less as far as potential is concerned, but way better for minimums. But way out of my league in terms of something that I can actually equip. I'll see if I can. Yeah, Dread can carry it around because Dread can carry everything. So here are the stairs that I thought We're over here. And... got a cute little room with nothing going on. This looks like there's something back there. It's an excellent point, Bananigan. And Dredd is literally used to carrying the entire party, so... you know, a few satchels full of food and, you know, some other stuff. Whatever. Super easy. Okay. Yeah, I thought the speed potion looked kind of funky. So I'm not sure I can brew this unless it's some, you know, similarly funky combination. So let's put that, like, there. Because there's no universe in which I don't give the speed potion to Dredd. It's just, like, what kind of nonsense would that be? Seriously, you know? Okay. So we have this. Ta-da! Another power gem. That puts me at 11. Out of 20. And should we care to, we can use one of the actually many gold keys that I've acquired to open this. Repeater. Okay, so it does 19 to 57, so 2 better minimum, 5 better potential. Range 3 cooldown is 6 seconds. Requires firearms 4, but has the special ability of repeat fire at 30, so she could use it 3 times. Fires a deadly hail of bullets. Hold down attack button to use. It's a fucking machine gun. Okay, Lara, apparently it's too much for her to carry around. I'm kind of curious, so... Before I slam dunk, keep this thing. So I have 75 rounds at the moment, so... well, let's find some poor bastard spider to use this on. You'll do just nicely. Come here. Come here. Okay. Holy shit. I mean, not great damage. And it is actually using the ammunition for all of the shots. Which, I mean, you know, like, is kind of expected, I think. I expected it to use the ammunition for the shots. I think it's 6 shots if my time delayed counting is worth anything. So 6 shots off of that. Not really a lot of damage for it though. And you know, with pellets being something of a premium. I mean, I like it, but is it worth the gold key? I don't know. So, anyway, let's... No. Just leave me alone. Okay, so... repeater gun, 6 shot auto, 6 shot auto, approximate arquebus damage, Eats ammo for breakfast, lunch, dinner. Normal attack does more damage than the previous gun. This is true. By a little bit. Not a tremendous amount, but a little bit. I think I said two additional gold keyhole. I think I said two minimum, five potential an increase itself. So that's something. So we have another gold keyhole over here with tin cannonballs and 50 pellets. So, I mean, you know, huzzah! Lots of ammo to burn through. I think I'm pretty done with this area. Unless I've, you know, completely missed something. But I don't think that I have. So, yeah. I think that's probably, like, a pretty good place to kind of stick a fork in it for the evening. However, I do want to go and take a look at some of the other gold key things that I do have access to. Now it's closed because I rushed through it. Holy crap, they're using wargs now. I mean, maybe you just picked the wrong fight, dude. Party is actually getting strong for, like, you know, the much weaker monsters. So... and by party, I mean dread, really. You know? Whoa. Okay. Ow. Someone's shooting! Is that that fucking leprechaun? Oh my god, it's back. Dude, I am... this leprechaun is gonna get it. I swear to God. Where is he? There he is. Okay. This dirty rat is going to die. And then... oh God. Oh, you fucker. Okay, Dread is heavily injured. Oh, don't you worry. I have something for you. Don't you worry. Get back here. Fucker. Oh, that 347 damage, though. Like, what is up? Oh, crap. Okay, Rattling Boss is now a regular enemy. That is unfortunate. That is really unfortunate. But you know what that means? Shit, it's got knockback!
Oh
fire the cannon? Ow. Dread is injured. Horribly. God, this thing's dangerous. Okay, the regular shot does not have knockback on the party. I don't know how many cannonballs I'm actually going to get from killing it, but I do have a surplus of some sort, so I'm kind of okay with using some. Okay, hand cannon. And a letter. Okay, apparently I'm not getting any cannonballs back. To the mightiest and most vicious beast of them all, be it known that the trespassers are responsible for the death of your twin brother. They came to the island not long ago, and already they have become a nuisance. Gather your kin and deal with them. What a prick! Well, rat twins, wrecked. Give me 5 more pieces of ammo. Can I knock the boss back into the spike room? I wouldn't imagine so. There is... or there are, I should say, weapons that have knockback associated with it. Like this maul. You know, knockback, special attack, massively powerful blow that pushes back enemies. But in my experience, it hasn't worked on, like, really big things. I remember it failing to work on something that was quite sizable. Like, I don't know. I don't remember what it was. Yeah, the hand cannon is, in fact, what Lara has. It is 15 kilograms and deals 40 to 120 damage, and Firearms 5 allows you to use Big Shot, which is what was knocking the entire party back. Dual-wield cannons. I think that's a job that only Dread is suited for, and Dread is not interested in cannonry. God Essence. I should mark that on the Fire Shrine as well. I already know what the air symbol is. God. God Essence. Also, this is the... Okay, now back to your previously scheduled programming. So there was a gold key thing in here. So I want to see what exactly this provides for the party as far as value is concerned. Maybe nothing too amazing, but... where's the keyhole? I marked it on the map. Oh, here it is. Heard something go down over here. So I guess it's this game. Or whatever. Rogue boots. Protection 5, dexterity 1. Ta-da! That's not bad. It might be some of the best protection that Lara's ever gonna get. Plus all of the dexterity is kinda nice. I'm still curious about this area, because it certainly shows up on the map as something relevant or interesting. And yet, hey, is that a rat? Yes, it is. I didn't find any, what do you call it, though? Secret buttons while I was racing around in here, trying to not die from the spikes. Anyway, here, let's load the quick save. That one seems like something that I'd quite like, but, you know, again, it's one of these things that's like, I don't know what's in the other ones, so. So, at least for now. So. Gold key opens. Rogue boots. Pro 5 dex plus 1. Now, as far as other gold key things were concerned, I remember there was one in here. Yeah, there's that big chest in there. Wonder if it's opened by a secret button in that area. I hope not. But yeah, there was a golden key slot with an axe in the ruins, which would take kind of a long time to get to. Maybe. This only goes to Shipwreck Beach, and here would be the fastest way of checking that out. Probably going this way. Oh shit. Time to run. This island is becoming an increasingly dangerous place. Jesus. I need more. Fuck. And there's turtles. Oh, crap. This is really bad. Holy crap, man. The shit they're throwing at me is just insane. I mean, these things on their own are a pain in the ass, but everything else? Cripes. Huh. Okay, then. Well, I know where I stand. Okay. I'll just swim up there, it's fun. Or it's not fine, I'm going to get shanked by, you know, mermaids. Okay. Are there like a billion things waiting here to kill me too? Fuck. So I need to go around this way. Yep. Can I actually extinct the island? I don't know. Probably not. Things seem to respawn. So, golden key. And here we have axe, which is a heavy weapon, which does 14 to 43. So, worse in terms of minimum and potential. It is a little bit faster than the saber. And also has flurry of slashes. So, yeah, just objectively worse than what I'm currently using. In, well, every way. I think they weighed the same. Maybe a point that it has going for it, that it's not any heavier. Okay, so, golden key slot. Let's get rid of that. So, axe. Heavy weapon, not as good as what I'm currently using. Meh. Okay, so, it's the big chest up there that I didn't know how to get to. Is the gold keyhole for that. There's the gold keyhole down here, gold keyhole down here. Probably would have been a good weapon if a gold key was used at the start of the game. Well, I'd already used a gold key prior to this point in the cache to get the Snake Charmer's cache, which was the one with the rope. There was some other stuff down here. I like different choices, you know. The magical alien dildo, that's not particularly good. The winds are guided by him and them. It's the silent one, Stonehenge. There's a ladder going down into the water. Why do I get the feeling that there's a secret button somewhere in here that I need to press? Fuck. Teleported to Stormbreach sewers in the archives. Oh, that would have been a quick way too. Maybe. I don't think I have any other gold keys that I'm like, oh, I so need to get that. Golden key thing. I'll remove that, because I already took what was in that chest. I think. Yeah, I did. So I don't think I have other gold key spots where I'm, you know, needing or wanting or requiring golden key usage. No, I think that's about it. The only one that I'd consider going and taking a look at again is the cache, just so that I can mark down exactly what's in there. So I think I might do that. How are we on levels? Let's see, so Dread and Wilson are actually at the same experience value, which is kind of interesting, given that, you know, I've been passing off the Spirit Mirror Pendant. I'll probably switch it back again once Wilson gets Air Magic 3 and is able to cast, you know, Meteor Rain. And I'll give it back to Dread at that point in time. And then, Lara and Shipwreck are a little ways away. So. Although, I mean, before I go anywhere. Yeah, I don't know about these, because these are much more natural-looking walls. So, I mean, it's entirely possible they have buttons on them. And it's just a button that's unfamiliar to me. But there's also the possibility that it's not really anything different. One other thing that I need to keep in mind, and I might do going toward the next stream, not something I'm going to do now, is the battle with the battle with the rocks in the summoning circle. This is irritating. You know, when I was running from everything that was trying to kill me, I thought I saw a switch in the water over here, so I'm going to take another look. Haha. I caught you, fish. Wait, what did that do? Where the hell is the ladder? Shit! Get me out of here. Okay. I opened some sort of secret gate over here. Why don't I just go this way? It's easier. I don't have to redo the goddamn puzzle again. It's a long way around, but whatever. Not very good. I'll add that as a note. Okay, this leads to the bog. And this leads me into the drink. I haven't actually explored over here. I imagine this goes into the bog. So I might avoid it for now. Huh, these things I know there's secret buttons on. Give me that. Ah. Alright, Pjox. Have a good one. Thanks for tuning in. Okay, let's see what's in here. It might be something not particularly good, because I could have gotten it much earlier. Reed leg mail. What's wrong with Shipwreck? Burdened? With what, a fish? What are you burdened with? Oh, the frost bombs that I gave you. Seriously? Hot damn. Okay, well. So, the leather cuisse is for protection, 4 plus 2 evasion. Sure. I'm gonna give that to Dread, and that I don't need. And I'll hand some of this stuff off to Dread. Because this will be stuff that I might ditch in the hub the next time I go there. Sailor bested by fish. Okay, so the cash. So, we already raided the Snake Charmer one, which is where I got... I guess I got the rope early, and apparently I missed this anti-venom. You know, super valuable, right? Okay, so... the Thief's Cache has Lockpick, Speed Potion, Broadhead Arrow, and the Crookhorn Longbow, which is 8 to 24 plus Dexterity. And it's light and has other things going for it. So, not amazing. 8 to 24 would be 29 to 45. So, probably better than the Arquebus in some respects. Because even I've got one skill point missile weapon, so even right now it's like an extra 20%. So, you know, if I was to continue putting points into missile weapons, then it gets better and better, but... but not like a... it's certainly not a thrilling bow in terms of how much better it is. So, Crookhorn bow. What was it? I can't remember. Like 6 to 24 damage plus dex, approximately. Lockpick, broadhead arrows, 4, I think, and speed potion. Okay. And then the paladin's cache. Has a healing potion, a heavy shield, and the fireblade. So the fireblade is 8 to 24 plus strength, which, I mean, it's basically like the lightning blade, only fire instead of lightning. And given the fact that I've been somewhat underwhelmed by the lightning blade, you know, the fireblade would be similarly underwhelming. It does have the bonus of doing fire damage, which again, hey, if I come up against something that's weak to fire, I'll just use Wilson. Same thing, I mean, like, air spells, like, that's a level 3 or a level 2 shock at this point in time. I still need level 3 air. But, I mean, when I get there, like, it's gonna be a pretty powerful shock spell, so... So yeah, even the lightning blade is just kind of... not particularly strong. And I wasn't noticing, like, a huge amount of damage improvement, actually, from, like, the skill. Because he has light weapons 5, right? Damage of light weapons by 20% for each skill point. I know. I'm guessing they're not like, you know, hey, 20%, and then the next level, oh, 40%. Like, I'm guessing it's multiplicatively, maybe. or something. So you're getting 20%, and then, you know, whatever the value is, it's like 20% of that, and then 20% of the next value, rather than, you know, 100% of the damage. Or at least doesn't seem to be the case. I don't know how the math works out. And I don't care about the Fireblade. So, weak healing potion. Heavy shield. Not great. And Fireblade. Underwhelming light weapon with fire damage. And I mean, again, you know, it's like, hey, concentration one to cast Fireball. Guess who else can cast Fireball? Oh, wait, Wilson can. So, now that just leaves the Conjurer's Cache. So it does have this Orb of Radiance, which I remember being decent when I looked at it the last time. Yeah, you get 15 energy, which is less than what I'm getting from the Shaman Staff, which is 25. Doesn't give willpower, and I thought it did, which means that it's worse than I remember. And this gives me 2 vitality. 10 health goes a long way. And it has light as a special attack, but I can just literally do that. So, pretty not good, and we have a weak energy potion. But over here we have the Archmage's Mantle, which is part of the Archmage's set. So 3 protection, 1 willpower, and resist all plus 10. Honestly, that's nice. Like, I probably won't find a better mage pants for Wilson. And it's really nice in the context as well of upping the resistances, because getting hit when the party gets hit by spells, usually everyone gets hit by the spell. So, you know, we get hit by a fire spell, everyone gets hit, we get hit by poison or cold or, you know, these sorts of things. So everybody's taking a pounding. So, you know, having an extra 10 resistances on, you know, like a weaker party member, that actually just seems like something I'd really like to have. Plus, I mean, the extra willpower, that's more energy, that's better energy regeneration rate, and, well, that's the same protection as the leather pants. So, I'm tempted to actually let that gold key use stand, because I actually quite like that, for Wilson at least. It's not a huge improvement, but then most of these aren't huge improvements, you know, as far as I can tell. I mean, I might come up against some other gold things that are, like, way, way better. Oh, there was this one. The loot of some kind. Shit, I have to go check that out. Ugh, fucking underwater buttons. Yeah, yeah, so there was a gold keyhole in there as well. Elemental weapons seem to be there more to complement a party without a dedicated wizard like Wilson. Yeah, they could totally be useful in those situations. For sure, but given the situation that I'm in, probably not. Taken. Yeah, I'm gonna let that stand. I mean, the rogue pants are, like, kinda good, but they're not amazing because Lara isn't scaling with dexterity with the firearms. So it's, you know, like, it's kinda one of those things where it's like, well, you know, it might be good. It might be fine. But I kind of get the feeling that that might be one of the best sets of pants that Wilson's ever going to get. His, not hands-on. So, should be a pretty quick trip down here. So, I believe it was in the, what is it, the sewers? Yeah. I have to go through that weird It's Dread wearing for... Oh yeah, that's why I dropped that. It's Dread has the bear skull helmet. If only there were other animal parts that Dread could wear for great effect. You know, dude, I know you didn't get the memo the last time I was down here. Ugh. Because I killed everyone, so no one was left to make a memo. But seriously, man, you know, like... Is this thing just running away? I'm fine with me. Who wants Toad Tongue? Okay, so it was up this way. I do have to say, I like the fact that enemies and stuff like that continue to respawn. Because I think if you were revisiting areas and there weren't additional enemies to kill, I mean, granted, you know, like a lot of them aren't going to be super challenging, a lot of them aren't going to provide, you know, like a lot of experience or something like that, so like if you were grinding them out for, you know, oh man, I want levels, let's grind, like, ugh. That would just be dreadful. But, you know, it still kind of keeps you on your toes. And I kind of like it. Crystal shield. That could be very good. Oh, and there's fish. Gimme. Get him. Get the fish. Get all the fish. I'm gonna drown. I think I missed one over there. Oh, I did. You can't escape from me, fish. Yeah, who needs a fishing rod, man? I just... Who needs it? Okay. This is really an obscene amount of food. I'm glad that they came back, because I fished all of the silver roaches out of that pond previously. Okay. Crystal shield, evasion 10. Wearer gains immunity to petrify condition. Seems nice. Heal, special attack. There's a heal spell in this game? Oh, I want it. I mean, I have potions, which are actually really good. So I guess the question is, do I want to hang on to this? Oh, right, I'm thinking it's like, oh, it requires concentration too. It doesn't require concentration, you know, I can just use it. It's heal that requires concentration too. So speaking of which, heal charges a bunch. Energy cost 50. Requires concentration. I wonder. So that's evasion 10 and immunity to petrify. This is giving immunity to petrify to shipwreck. So it's not super useful. Pardon me. Perhaps I'll do that. And then... I don't know. I'll give that to Wilson. Lara could do with it. But Wilson's weaker. And more valuable. By the way, I need potions and stuff. So... Yeah, I don't have a problem with using a gold key there. It's one, two. I am now a master alchemist. Two. And then, sure, I can give one of those to this guy. just obscene. But ain't it grand? Okay. Alright. Crystal shield. Can't use. Definitely does make me think that there is some sort of heal spell, though. And chances are it's gonna be, I don't know, some kind of combination that I don't know or understand. I might not have the requirements for it either. Because it's probably like, I don't know, water or air or earth or something. Still haven't had any additional thoughts on what these circles mean. I haven't really been ruminating on it in-game much. I've just sort of been playing and doing other things. Haven't found any more clues. I'll remove these because I've taken it. But yeah, I think I was hoping I would maybe find something else that would lead me in a direction that would help out with that. So, the caches that are left down here are probably not worth taking. I do have one gold key remaining. And I could use it to get the rogue set. Like the rogue boots. But I don't know. Let's get out of the water. Surprise! Come on, Dredd, you're the one with all the accuracy. It also strikes me that I should unequip the the mortar and pestle, because I'm pretty sure you can, you know, fire that at people. At least I've got Meteor Storm. I don't have Meteor Storm. I only have Air Magic 2. I do have the scroll for it, though, if that's what you mean. Which it probably is, because you know that I don't have Air Magic 3 yet. Wait. Yes. So, I've taken a look at those gold caches. That's kind of nice. Where do I get out of here? Windgate to surface. Good. So, as far as the township goes, I've done basically the things that I need to do there. Because I went through the crystal mines, and I found maybe everything? Ho ho ho, now I have a machine gun. Oh, I want it. I could just go get it, but... Well. There's ammunition there as well. And then I got the air essence here. There's this stuff. I could maybe take another look. Like a very serious look at all of the walls around here and try and see what's kind of going on in relation to maybe some secret areas here. I still have work that needs to be done here with this island and also this potential. Because it says the gate to Fifth Shrine is hidden from sight. I don't know if it means this. Probably not. It's a little on the nose, but it might be something secret, and there might be secret walls underwater, fucking bastards, that I need to check out. And I also need to find a way to get onto the island, still. which seems to have an elemental shrine. But I don't have the power gems to kind of support it. At least not now. So there's that, then there's the cemetery still, and the bog. I'm kind of curious about how to potentially open the pyramid. You know, need a key or something. But I don't know. I mean, it could be possible that, like, maybe I'll find something in the graveyard, because pyramids are a place for, you know, royalty long since dead, so who knows? Maybe the key is buried somewhere. But one thing I do know is where I'm going to be going at the start of the next stream. And it's not in the bog. I am not going to the bog. Fuck that. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I remember the secret button that I've seen on this tile set being, like, super obvious. So, I'm gonna be coming here for payback. Oh, man. Don't know what's in there. Maybe it's like a skill point or something? It has to be so good. It has to be really good. I could just do this now. But I might just get my ass kicked. Alright. I'm gonna fight these things now. Maybe. I hope. Alright, Dread's God. Maybe I won't use the speed potion, but I'm definitely gonna use the rage potion. Because I am angry. Angry at these things. I am gonna swap this out here. Because I do... These things have armor. It's just a fact. The lightning blade is gonna be better in this fight. I could use some cannonballs rather than the arquebus. I've got 4 left in this one, and then I have another, what, 10? But maybe I don't need to, because Dread's dishing out the punishment. And then I've got all kinds of fire scrolls. Also, these bombs. I remember the bombs being a really good thing. So I think the strat for me is going to find myself into a corner where I'm only available to be hit or cornered by 2 things, and then I'll be using the barrier spell to basically get one of them to fuck right off, and then just bash the hell out of the next one and continue doing that. And everybody's got potions and stuff. So, yeah, let's do this. This may be an ass whooping, but not for me. Yeah. having a nice time. Well. Yeah. That was an ass kicking. Lightning sword against rocks, poor K. Well, I mean, the idea was it does lightning. Does it not do... Yeah, it does shock damage, right? Damage, shock, 8 to 24 plus strength. Whereas this does, you know, not shock damage. And I was thinking, hey, these things have lots of armor. So if they have lots of armor, maybe they don't have a lot of, like, lightning resistance. So the lightning blade would be better. It didn't appear to be so. It appeared to be kind of weak on the whole. So anyway, Tome of Knowledge. Sweet. I had a feeling it was going to be something like this. They had these in the first Grimrock game, and I figured if I had to fight those four guys to get a tome of some sort, I had a feeling that it was going to be really, really good. So, I guess the question is just what I want to spend it on. I'm pretty close to a level with Wilson, so I don't necessarily need to get air magic. Or I could just get air magic right now and, you know, kind of move on from there. With Shipwreck... I mean, the amusing thing is, because of where I'm putting points currently, Shipwreck skill points are non-critical. In the sense that, you know, the stuff that I'm getting now is improving Shipwreck, but it's not getting us somewhere where we're not already getting, in a sense. You know, like, there's no utility, there's no huge, major, crazy thing. I mean, at 5th level, you can backstab with any light weapon. That is legit cool. You know, if I get, like, a really sweet light weapon sword that's actually really good for Shipwreck, then backstabbing with it will be really good. Problem is, most of the enemies in this, particularly in contrast to Grimrock 1, are a lot faster in terms of how they move around, and more creative in how they move around. So, like, the larger wargs will move adjacent to you and turn in the same movement. So, you know, like, backstabbing them is almost impossible. And there's a lot of other things. Like, I mean, you know, the rats move very quickly. A lot of other creatures move very quickly. So there isn't some major necessity for me to start backstabbing. Sure, you know, things that are slower, like ogres and that kind of thing. That's pretty good, but, you know, I'm still a ways from getting it, and I don't need to get it right now. With respect to Dread, yeah, just beefing up his accuracy. I want Dread to hit, because Dread hits hard. Dread hits really hard. Lara, same kind of deal. I've been putting points into accuracy, and it's been working out kind of okay. I may, particularly because of the dexterity that she does have and that she's gaining from the rogue set, I may just start pumping some points into missile weapons to balance out the firearms and that kind of thing. And have it as more of a regular weapon, because I have been easing up on using Lara and, like, the firearms, like the arquebus, just because I know that it's a limited amount of ammo. So I'm only really taking it out in, you know, fights where it counts. You know, it's like, I really need to win this, and now. Whereas if she had a bow, you know, I can just have her attack like everybody else. But Wilson, you know, like, these skill points are going places. You know, even if... Because, you know, it's like, oh, well, then I could put it in air magic, and then I could get more stuff in earth magic or water magic. Like, I'm adding so much more utility to the party by adding skill points in here. I think I did the same thing in Grimrock 1 as well with the mage that I had, which was number 6 from the prisoner. I'm pretty sure that's where I put the skill books. Because they came a little bit later in the game, and I was in a similar position. Wait, would third level of armor make Dread get loads of free dodge? No. No, third level of armor just gets Dread another 5% of protection from equipped armor pieces. At fourth level, you can wear heavy armor without penalties. Which is a thought. But for the moment, I want Dread. I want Dread to hit. And Dread's accuracy is not particularly good, because Dread's dexterity is not particularly good. That critical, though. Sweet. So, anyway, I've done a lot of yammering, so I'm just going to have Wilson use this. And then we're going to put in air magic. And now we have Meteor Storm. Now we have Meteor Storm. So how do I go about casting Meteor Storm? Okay. So it's a U at the top. And not including the bottom row. Unleashes a devastating storm of meteors on your foes. Sweet. Let's save before I cast this, because who knows, the game might have a sense of humor and just totally destroy my party with it. That's pretty hot. Oh! That was 80 energy for that one spell. Still, why do I get the feeling that it's pretty good? It's a fireball machine gun? Yeah, basically. It's like the repeater that I could have gotten for Lara, only with fire spells and with a replenishable ammo base. Hell yeah. So, on that note, yeah, it's just kind of a case of where I'm going next. Kinda sorta done with this area, might have. Secret walls to investigate. I'll put that down just that I know that's something that I am concerned about. Yeah, a repeater except on fire. Almost looks like there's stuff down here, like secret stuff. What is going on there? Are there more exits from this thing? Qua? Another exit to the woods? You got this stuff on the map. You know, which I'm like horribly cheating because, you know, normally you wouldn't see this kind of stuff. But I don't care. This is how the game works, at least for now. So yeah, the only other things that I have kind of going on, there was the big chest that was up here that I have no idea how to get to, which I could revisit at a later time. It might be underwater buttons, but I don't think a secret button down here would affect something on a floor above it. It could. But, yeah. So I think I might head off in the direction of the what do you call it? The cemetery. Still don't know what to do about that code. I'm not giving up on that, certainly. And this. Lots to do, lots and lots and lots to do in this game. I'm curious about this as well. Because what was it that this one said? Yeah, the Silent One has a friend who is more willing to speak. Head towards the sunrise beyond the gate to find him. So there's the Silent One. The stone head that doesn't say anything. So, You know, perhaps he has a friend in the graveyard that is going to tell us something of value. But it won't be tonight. Because I am going to call it there.